part where we invite all of the angels and archangels of all times and in all places is our invitation for those we have lost to join us who are here in our tangible bodies to be present for this bread and this wine, this great meal that we can share. We repeat and echo through time those words of our ancestors in faith who taught us most of these words, and in our saying them, in our sharing of these communion elements, we join ourselves also to the past. So we remember that deep dark night when Jesus gathered with the disciples, took the bread, blessed it, and gave thanks, and gave it to all to eat, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you." Again, after supper, Jesus took the cup, blessed it, and gave it to all to drink, saying, "This is the cup, the covenant of my blood shed for you for the entire forgiveness of all of your sins, so that any time you eat of this bread or drink of this cup, you may do so remembering me." May that Holy Spirit that has encouraged people in all times and places to be inspired to do justice, to know when to keep quiet for their safety, and when to shout songs of praise when they can. May that Holy Spirit be within and through this bread and wine, that it may be holy food for us, God's holy people. May that same Holy Spirit be in, with, and through, so ever stuck to you, that when people see you, they see God. And we bless this food in our singing, in those ancient words of prayer that we have been taught.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today
thank you. too.
Yeah. May the blessings of God smell as wonderful as coffee hour while they're up the stairs right now. May your blessings from God be so abundant that you have more than enough to share. May the blessings of God be like cool aloe to all of the bits of you that have been sunburnt by the world. May the blessings of God be like a quenching oasis that we carry with us like humpback camels that pass us 3 weeks or so. As we look at our announcements, one of my favorite announcements of the day is just a thank you to Katie, who has hosted a youth choir here at the congregation for the last 2 weeks, and the sounds of young people running around have been quite a blessing to this space, and it's been warm enough that the windows were open so the whole neighborhood got to enjoy the beauty of the singing that was happening in this space. And a particularly special thank you from a congregation who has tried mightily in the past to have music opportunities for kids in the summer and not had it turn out. So congratulations and thank you. You'll notice on your back page of the announcements that some of the weekly activities are listed in this tree that I made.
Cool tree.
Cool tree.
I like it.
Music night this week is Tuesday from 7 to 10. If you haven't been yet, it's a lot of fun. Ashley is one of those amazing musicians that I am jealous of, that if someone just calls out the name of a song, she figures out what key they're singing it in and just makes up the chords that go along with it. So we've been singing people's favorite hymns. We've been singing beautiful songs from the radio. Most of the music, we have all the different types of sheet music or lyrics for, but it's lots of fun if you want to stop by. I want to let you know that the second Tuesday in August, because that's the night of our council meeting, we're gathering at 4 p.m. So if there are folk in the congregation who typically wouldn't come because you don't like to drive at night, the August 11th music night might be just for you. Can't think of any other announcements. There might be some, but Sally will tell you they're probably a copier. Okay.
I have one announcement. This is just publicity. The San Francisco Cable Car Chorus meets in the basement to practice on Wednesday night. And last week they got up at 4:30 in the morning to go sing at the opening of the San Francisco Marathon. Uh-huh. And so they had to get up really early to go down and do that. So they are doing things outdoors.
Yeah.
There's
also a group that is meeting here every Saturday morning at 10 o'clock. They're working on singing for a concert called Street Requiem, which is about homeless people who have passed away all over the world. And it's a fancy, it's easier to sing than you imagine, but the concert will be very fancy as Frederica Monstade will be the soloist. If you're a music person, you know who she is. I just pretend I know who she is because everyone tells me she's fancy when I say it. So let me know if you want more info about that. I can email you or you can find the info on.